or get eaten.
Right.
That's right. All right. So let's see these pours.
That's candy. What happened? You're just looking?
All right. These final pours should be ready to be up.
Follow!
You get a pour cam, Roski? You get a pour cam? Pour cam? Pour cam.
Ooh, all right, here we go.
And two similar pours that Peter's lines were just a little heavier and stronger, definitely would have given up on my first one.
You know, disappointing pour for Peter Kim, but you know, that's the competition. It looks like that espresso is pretty thick there, Joe.
Yeah, I think espresso can always be a little tricky as well. Some people will make sure to get a really good heavy swirl on the espresso to just completely break it up and make it a little bit more smoother. I've also seen other competitors add a touch of milk, swirl it, and then drop their milk. What's your approach with a heavy espresso, huh?
I will swirl that bad boy. I will take the moment, those 10 seconds, because remember, I'm only pouring once, to really swirl that bad boy. If you see these pores, this crema, the crema is eating up this milk. So these are the challenge. A little bit of a darker roast this time for this competition, Joe. How do you feel about that?
I mean, listen, if the heavier, the better, in my opinion, because you can always work with a heavier espresso and mild it down, so to say, where if you have something just a little too light, there's no going back. You can't add anything to it. At least not here in these competitions.
Yeah, and that's another factor. We don't know what espresso will be used until we get here. So all these pours at home, the game has changed.
There we go. So we have Eddie versus Sam. We got Sam on the blue machine and Eddie over on the yellow. Sam, amazing latte artist and also owner of Scorpio
Coffee. Yeah,
that's right.
Yes. Shout out Puppuccino in
that's
the building.
Right. The legend himself. And then we got the young blood. Who we got out there?
We got Eddie. Eddie's our head judge tonight, Joe.
Ooh, that's
at our Isam Lucky's kickoff party. He's going to be our head judge. He also is our Isam SCA after party winner with CC's Mortar Coffee Call. So.
like, I mean, it's a swan. It's a little loose on the head on the top, so that's why I say that. And then Eddie has a wing 1-1. Looks like he kind of forced that top part.
Yeah.
So instead of a heart forming and then him going through, it kind of dragged it like a butter knife kind of cutting through bread toast.
Again, the espresso wins this round again. Eating of these four is alive. Four baristas are...
Damn. Espresso 2, barista 0.
Nicely, we have Marcelo representing LA, Erica, and Keys to the Shop Chris as our judges today. But shout out to the first swan.
Yes,
in this competition, rare situation where baristas are pouring swans.
Yeah, I mean, so Sam is known for his double or triple head swan. So it looks like that's what he kind of tried to do, but towards the end might have ran out of flame and just had more milk.
Yeah.
Sam and Eddie.
That's bad.
Sam, moving on.
All right.
Wait, have you seen Gabe?
Gabe? I have not
seen
Gabe.
So Gabe is next on deck, and...
We will see. Maybe we get our first
Alejandro.
Alternate.
Do we have our first alternate?
Maybe
that's what I'm asking.
Maybe we have our first alternate. But Gabe's from L.A., so...
Gabe should be here, but I'm
unless traffic is that bad, Joe.
Oh, Gabe. There is Gabe. The blue shirt. He's out of here.
He's there.
Hey, let's go.
L.A. native. Up next, we got Gabe. We got Alejandro.
Gabe and Alejandro. Let's go, Gabe.
Alejandro was competing at Barista League yesterday, Joe.
Let's go, baby. Si se puede.
All right.
We got Battle of the Giants, Gabe. Like,
Latino gang over here.
Alejandro, like 6'5".
It's all love. Beautiful segment. All love. Don't get me wrong. When I go up against you, I am taking you down. But it's not that serious. It's all love. It's all about getting better. It's about meeting new people, right? Like,
yeah, because if you win or lose, you probably make a friend after this. And that's the beauty behind it. My first coffee fest, I had to face Emily Bryan for the top 16. And now we're like the closest friends, so... Shout out, two-time Latte Art World Barista Champion, Emily Bryant.
Literally had Japanese barbecue and donuts.
Not too long ago for her birthday. So we'll see.
It was so yummy.
We'll see.
What are you doing, buddy?
Yeah, look, the LA scene is serious, you know? They have a strong presence. It's good to see representation here in the city. And here we go, Joe. Gabe versus Alejandro.
Oh, yeah, I mean, listen, West Coast, as they say, got bangers, man. You guys can fucking pour out here, bro. I mean, and it goes up to down. I mean, you got Portland people that pour their ass off, L.A., and then you start coming on down, going to Texas, et cetera. I mean, like...
Yeah, West Coast is definitely loaded, you know what I mean? You know, it's, you know, definitely, definitely great to see different baristas from all parts of the country. You know,
East Coast got some.
We got some representation out here, Joe. Always.
Maybe we're a little biased, you know, New York. Just saying.
Just a little bit.
Poquitito.
Poquitito. You know, but we'll see. We'll see. You know. Let's see if they can conquer the espresso, Joe. Let's see if they can conquer the espresso. We will see.
Hey, Ethan, you got a pen or something?
30 seconds left, baristas.
Cool, yeah, Barry, we're just fixing the color, but we should be back and rolling.
Ooh, we got beautiful clear cup.
You've never seen that, by the way.
Well, I mean, the clear cups are very rare. They tend to be a little bit more delicate.
Yeah.
And honestly, the milk just never flows the way I want it to, and whenever I pour it in a clear cup, ceramics just always give me a better pour.
You're officially a West Coaster, nicely. Sorry. It's okay.
Let's go. Bring the smoke, Papa. Yeah, having a legend like you come. Let's get it.
Oh, man.
By the way, next thing will be also one of our judges at Throwdown tonight. So
we'll see. Let's go.
Let's get it.
Got it. I think there's strategery in there.
All right.
Oh, is that even a word? Strategery?
Yeah.
Apparently.
Let's get it.
Hashtag
step up your vocabulary.
Yeah, these beautiful baristas are with these beautiful vessels. Like, I am impressed. I'm impressed.
15 seconds. Oh, Alejandro point and a these are beautiful cups, by the way.
What is that, 8 9 ounce?
It's gotta be 10 ounce.
Oh,
let's go. By the way, if you do not drop your cup in time, I am very sorry. There's just nothing.
It's hard out here.
Yeah. You gotta drop your cup. There's no sympathy. They do not care.
Oh, nice. Let's go.
Game on a beautiful base. Nice heavy lines.
Oh, yeah.
Something out of contrast. The symmetry. Alejandro has a little symmetry.
Team Blue Machine wins this game again.
Team Blue Machine may win again. But you know what? I don't think Team Espresso won this. I think they took down Team Espresso.
Yeah. Can't say the same thing about Alejandro, but
it's okay.
Know, it's tough out here. They need to swirl their espresso.
Hashtag swirl your espresso.
I guess so. You have a cord for the iPad.
All right, looks like our judges.
Right side, yeah.
Those scores up. Let's see who's moving on the next
round. Right side, indeed.
All right, well, great job, Dale. It's two guys. moving on to the next round is Gabe.
Duke
and
Blue.
That's fine, Duke and Blue. Team Blue.
Team Blue.
Whoa. Excited for this round.
It's like we had it planned with the blue shirt, Joe.
Sure.
Like we had it planned.
Up on deck, we got Turner versus Agnes. I know Turner many times has placed. Has Turner a former champion?
I believe he's a former champion, Joe.
Okay.
I believe he has gotten one, but not in a while. He's got maybe 4 consecutive second places. He's looking for gold. He's here for business.
Ooh, let's go. And the outfit's always on point.
Outfit's on point.
Always.
Is that a cheetah, Joe?
Is it a cheetah?
Cheetah. Jaguar. I'm not sure.
I'm going, I guess jaguar. I like that.
Jaguar. Maybe a jaguar.
Yeah, I'd be more afraid of a jaguar than a cheetah, so I'm going to say jaguar.
Cool. We're just getting out.
Here we go. Barista Maddie with the assist. Former champ and 7 trophies.
Wow.
Former champ with 7 trophies.
Thank you, Maddie. Yes.
I appreciate you.
Yes. Definitely a former champion. 7-time trophy winner.
Let's go.
Yes. That's a bad one.
So it's not Red Machine, it's Yellow Machine. But no, I don't think the Yellow Machine has won, or Yellow Machine has like 1 win and it's just all blue.
Yeah, I think only Emil has won. The Yellow Machine, Joe. Everyone.
And then on deck, we have Justin Wong and Renhan Su. Also known as Underfill Su. Love them.
All right, all right. Ready? Good sportsmanship up here.
Thank you.
We just need subtitles.
All right, we can work on that.
I mean, listen, this is a work in progress.
Yeah. Captions nicely.
All right.
We're working on it.
Just for you, nicely. We'll put out English and Spanish. Para que lo sepa. Love you.
We'll see you later.
Yes. I need a coffee from you at some point when we out here.
All right.
Oh, it got quiet out here, man.
Yeah,
you can feel, you get almost goosebumps. You can feel
feel it's like the intensity out here.
Yeah. I mean, everybody knows what's on the line, Joe. You know, these baristas are traveling, spending thousands of dollars on their flight for this moment right here.
Not to mention the hours of practice, the gallons of milk, pounds of coffee that they've also had to go through to prepare.
The scrolling your opponent and observing their pores. Yeah, we know you all do it.
No, we don't.
Way cool. Turner looks confident up there, Joe. We'll see what he can do.
Yeah, I mean, Turner already seems to be pouring first.
I mean, I've had the pleasure of going up against Turner, and he's extremely precise and very quick.
Yeah, he is a one-pour barista. We will see.
Yeah. Right now we have Agnes swirling the espresso. Let's go, Agnes. That's a job.
Word's getting out, definitely.
Word's going out. Tell a friend to tell a friend. Swirl your espresso. Swirl your espresso.
Very cool. Turner with the speed point.
Bitter Zoet. Unfortunately, Kelvin did not move on, but Kelvin did have a strong pour.
He did have a strong pour.
Yes.
And the pounds of meat they got there.
Very true, Barry. Very true. It's legal out here. All right. We get a wow from the crowd.
And by the way, Barry, where weed can be good, CBD is actually better. It's a little bit more mellow and calming.
Yes.
But what do we know? We make coffee.
Yeah, this is why we commented. All right, Joe, we got some beautiful pours. What's your first initial reaction? What do you think? Who do you think got it?
First thing I'm looking at are the bases. You got two strong bases. Agnes is a touch stronger because of the symmetry, in my opinion. Now, Turner does have
speed point.
Speed as well as difficulty.
He definitely has difficulty.
Right? But Agnes still has a foot bump that's heavy and strong and a touch more symmetrical, which makes it more cleaner all around.
I think Turner may get this just because of the top part on Agnes's pour. I know the judges are big on execution and making sure that they follow through. As you see, Chris looking at it, observing it.
I was gonna say nicely, and not to say squeaks by, but I mean, it's. I can see where you're coming from. We all know what Turner can throw down. So this is maybe not one of his stronger first pours.
Yeah, like well said nicely. I think Turner is going to squeakly get by here.
Or possibly we might have an upset. Let's go.
We will see. There's definitely those that happen.
Yeah.
We'll see. Justin Wong and our fellow New York native Sue is up.
On deck.
Yeah.
Where's Sue?
Sue is out there.
Sue's not in the blue, but he's not on the blue machine. That's not a good sign.
I know.
I didn't say it that way. Hashtag
blue machine.
Blue machine curse. Everybody on the blue machine has one.
Yeah, except one. Yeah.
So if you're on the blue machine,
it's looking good for you. Okay. So then maybe interesting. I'm gonna see if we can get some first day checkups on the machine, making sure no one's at a disadvantage.
Yeah, I mean, listen, if there is a technical failure, as in espresso is not coming out properly, or there's just no steam coming through on the machine, you can request a timeout.
Yeah,
and the judges themselves will go up there and make sure everything is great.
Josh, what's good, baby? Get in here. So right now we got the MC, Mr. Joshua Boy. Josh, how you doing, bud?
Very good. Very good.
Good.
Josh, who do you like, left or right?
You know, honestly, it all comes down to the definition, and to me, Agnes, to me.
Yeah, I was saying.
And I just think, I think they're having troubles with the structure. This espresso is a little bit darker than usual.
Yes.
And I feel like they're having a hard time getting that structure. But
So we have had Team Espresso 3 and Barista 0 because the espresso just unfortunately seems to keep overpowering the milk. But some of them are starting to get the grasp of swirling. Maybe you can give a little
a
cool tip to just swirl it so that they're good.
Yeah, I think you got to put more in.
All right, so here's the moment.
Here we go. Oh, we got split decision. Let's go. All right, split decision. Holy shit.
Agnes won.
Sorry, I'm cursing.
Dice K.
1-1, let's see who's moving on to the next round. Erica.
Squeaks by. Joey.
Let's go, Joey. How you doing, baby?
The first split decision of the night.
Joe. I mean, listen, I have to agree with Joshua. I think Agnes had that one. At the same time, Agnes is on the top of the game. That could have been different. Taking any pours for granted and making sure that every one you pour is your strongest.
Yeah, I mean, we would have seen Waterworks if Daisuke didn't get that one, so let's go Turner.
It would have been quite the upset.
Yes, quite the upset. But shout out Agnes, she pours so fire.
Let's go, Justin.
Let me get a switch cam.
I don't think Justin's gonna get that.
Yeah. I don't think neither are.
But Sue is taking his first board. He's on the first
lead. I think Espresso is winning this round, Joe, from the faces.
Let's go.
You know, sometimes you gotta make the choice. If you don't like your pour, but you don't have time, you gotta get that speed point. Every point matters at that point.
Especially if you go to like a day three, it's huge. It really does matter.
Yeah. Let's go, Justin.
Alright, come on, Justin. Come on, Justin.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Yes!
Down the plate! On the plate! Listen, if you don't make it on the plate, they don't even try to look at it. It's just like, oh, so sorry, you missed the plate.
Oh,
it's
man.
Very important.
Ooh, good battle here. Good battle here. Man, that espresso is tough. That espresso is tough.
I can hear you on the espresso, but it unfortunately looks like Sue ran out of oil towards the end.
Right.
And Justin maybe could have been a little bit more texturized on his milk to get the heavier base on the front. But other than that, I think Justin did a really great job. I mean, symmetry. Contrast,
yeah, he did submit his first pour, so he didn't go for a second pour. It's always so hard. But yeah, I think Justin did enough to get him over the hump. Unfortunately, Sue without a top heart, it's really difficult. I know he's upset.
Okay, let's see what the judges have to say.
All right, moving on to the next round is going to be. Justin!
Hey. Oh, Justin! Well done, Justin.
Close win.
Hey, there is nothing like your first dub at one of these, okay? Even if it's only the first round, I mean, there's nothing like your first win.
All right. So next up, we have Nestor, who I don't think is here, versus Nick Grayer. So first alternate is going to be called up. Wondering who it's going to be.
No.
Yeah, he's not here. No, he's from New York.
Okay, no, Nestor. So we're going to go our first alternate of the day.
Woo!
First alternate.
Let's go. So what they're doing now is they're allowing everyone to sign up, and they're drawing random names as like a lottery.
Yes, Justin won.
Zero.
Yes, Justin won. That's correct.
Eight.
Oh.
Oh, who's that?
0-2. All right.
Hey.
Vanessa, guys, come on up.
Vanessa.
Vanessa,
winning the raffle. Alternate.
Yeah, first alternate. Let's go.
So if you're not familiar,
let's go, Vanessa.
They are now doing a raffle to earn your alternate. Before, you just rush Chris or Joshua to sign your name on the list. We've changed things up, and now a raffle is being picked, and Marissa is here to pour.
Yeah, it's amazing what can happen when a riot pops up at a latte art competition. To make life a little easier on everyone, to just have the raffle, which I actually appreciate, you know, because if you unfortunately misheard what time to sign up, now doing this, you have an opportunity to be the last one to sign up and still get a chance to pour, which is huge.
Yeah, it's super great.
Yeah. Let's hear it for them.
Trip Coffee Collective in the house, Chi-Town. What's good, baby? Have an amazing event to get this up and running, by the way. But we have Vanessa versus Nick. Vanessa, team Blue Machine. Nick, team Yellow.
Peru has the majority of the wins. Yellow has only taken one win so far.
Yeah. So
not to say that, you know, you have to be on the brewing machine, but it it seems to favor you in this competition.
Yeah. So we'll see. We'll see what happens.
All right,
two new faces in the competition, Joe.
Yeah.
Well, it seems like Nick working pretty fast, by the way.
Yeah.
Already has a
beautiful pink cup.
Yes.
Love it.
Looks like an origami,
but I could be wrong.
Could be right, sir.
Looks like he's a
Vanessa seems to be pouring as well.
Drink coming down.
Oh, we're going for a second one.
Going for a second one. Oh, looks like they're both going for a second one, Joe.
See, but she did it. She played it smart. She didn't move too far away from the machine. She just set it up. I mean, you want to make sure that when you are up there, you are taking as little steps left or right, vice versa, as possible. I mean, I pull two shots when I'm up there, and then I pull my first one. Right, so I grind my first shot, tamp. I grind my second shot, tamp. I pick them both, and I just pull one, and I use one. And then I use my second one, which I've had to, and still, I guess the espresso holds and still does good. What's your take on that, Austin?
Well, all I gotta say is you wanna decide immediately if you're gonna pour for a second one. You don't wanna ponder for those 3-4 seconds, because those 3-4 seconds you may need those at the end. So, like, these baristas now, they need to sit in.
Come on,
Vanessa. Put it down.
Come on, Vanessa.
First DQ, Joe.
See if we were able to at least see some of the drink.
Yeah, let's see if we can
get some of the drink. We got the drink.
Should be coming out real soon. Oh, they gotta move their cup.
Oh, they didn't move the cups onto the tray.
Okay. First DQ, Nick Blair to speed things up. We're just gonna go on to the next match.
So once again, shout out Nick, taking down Vanessa.
Yeah. Next up, Joe, fellow LA native, Juan Gutierrez.
That's right, we got Juan and June. Shout out to June, always showing love to us. Very consistent and strong pourer. I definitely don't want to go up against June in one of these competitions.
You gotta love June. Anywhere we're at, June has been at. He's been at all the coffee fests. He's a real, real big fan. He supports all our events. Big shout out to June.
Yeah, I mean, Juan as well. We've had the pleasure of visiting Juan many times at Aminati's and working and hanging with him. One of the homies, it's one of the, he's one of the reasons why we love coming out here to the West Coast.
Yeah, man. Shout out Juan. He's another West Coast battle right here.
It's going to be fun. I'm looking forward to this competition.
Yeah, we got to meet Juan years ago when he was first starting off in coffee, and now he's the head manager of Manali's,
Okay. I mean, now, maybe, let's see if we can do this one. Can we guess the pour? So, I'm going to say June is going to do a wing, like 3-1 or something. And I'm going with like a Rosetta Revolution kind of thing for Juan. What do you think? Am I right or wrong? What do you think?
Well, it is very risky to throw a Rosetta with his espresso, Joe. So, I'm hoping he doesn't.
Not if you swirl it.
Not if you swirl it.
Swirl that.
Barry looks like Juan's gonna do a rosetta. I think he may be right on this. He may have hit the nail on the coffin with these two pours, Joe. Let's see if you're right.
Yeah, I mean, listen, you honestly never know when someone's gonna pour when they're up there in front of that machine. with that being said, with enough times competing up against your fellow coffee professional, you can kind of already know. Or some of them have a signature. For example, Hob has his signature pour.
I only pour Wing Wing 3 and with your occasional sprinkle.
Heavy, strong, and hard.
Especially in the first round, right?
Yeah.
In the, when you go to the later rounds, you want to step it up a little bit. You're facing the big dogs. So we'll see. We'll see what they do.
Here we go. So right now we have both June and Juan.
Looks like Juan is doing a tulip.
Both June and Juan. Boring. They have dropped their cups in front of the machines.
Looks like Juan's going for a second.
Going back for a second. Yeah, let's go.
And June's going for that speed point. And he gets it.
All right. June dropping it. And now you may hear some say speed point doesn't matter. And you'll hear some that say speed point matters. In my opinion, any point you can get is always a benefit. So. It's up to you what you want to do, right?
Yeah. I mean, every point counts.
Yep.
We'll see.
Juan in the zone with the headphones. That's right.
He's got 10 seconds. He's got to drop it. He's not going to have enough.
Juan, drop it. Drop it. Time is up. Our second DQ.
Heartbreak.
June, moving on.
Heartbreak. It gets tough. We're not getting no force.
I love it. Well said. Josh was saying it. That clock is no joke. And then the assist from the espresso.
It's a wrap. Next round. Let's go. All right, so Juan DQs, we got Troy
and Daniel.
All right. Troy.
All right, Troy taking the brew machine. Let's go, Troy. Let's go, baby. Troy, probably our rookie of the year out of New York City last year.
Yes.
One of our strongest competitors. Proud to cheer him on. Let's go.
Yeah.
Right now we're looking for possibly our second alternate.
No, Daniel.
Second alternate. There we go. This is like the Royal Rumble when the clock winds down and someone runs into the ring.
That's right.
You never know who they're gonna call. Let's go.
7.
Oh, they're calling a number and no one is blowing up. Uh-oh.
Coffee, doing big things. You can find him in New York at Love Carbo.
Young UJ, strong compliment, and I highly very much agree.
Yes. Big shoes to fill.
Okay, we finally got an alternate. Who we got?
All right.
I think we got an alternate.
Yes.
Alright, Corey Reynolds, our second alternate. I mean, they called two numbers and people didn't answer. Sorry, I'm not going to sign up for something and then not stay.
Alright. Troy's out here trying to steam Juan, trying to get comfortable with the machine. know, every little kink matters, you know, the timing of the espresso machine, the timing of the steam wand, the grinder, making sure that it's a fresh shot. All these factors should be considered when you go up there, right? You may not think about it at your coffee shop, but here in the World Latte Art stage, every little piece towards your design matters.
I mean, nicely, the good news is you still have two more days to drive down, my brother.
Should drive down tomorrow, nicely.
Yeah, bro, you drive down tomorrow, we'll put you up here with us. Come hang out with us.
Come hang out with us.
That'd be fun.
All right.
Let's go, Troy. Troy, Corey. Hey, I love it. Well done.
Hey.
All right. Got the pearls?
Got the pearls.
Let's go.
All right. So, to save time, Troy is pulling his shot and putting milk into his pitcher.
Right before initiating anything.
Yes.
You can't have milk in your pitcher before starting, and you can't have coffee already grounded in your portafilter.
Yeah.
You can have your milk set up next to your pitcher, and you can have your portafilter in your hand before time starts, but that's as good and as close as you can get.
Yeah, but it does make a difference. You save a couple of seconds.
It makes a huge difference if you set it up properly. You can actually pour your milk into your steaming pitcher while you're literally grinding the coffee into your portafilter.
Yeah.
And that is huge, and I've seen many, many greats, including Twiz, use that. It saves seconds, and that goes a long way.
Like nicely said, seconds are huge in this competition, as you've seen so many disqualifications, rushes, second pours.
Yeah, man. Hashtag workflow. Because you know what? If you're doing all of that and you're making this and setting it up as quickly as possible, you will have no problem getting in your second pour if you feel it's needed. 60
seconds. Yeah. We'll see.
60 seconds.
Looks like Corey's getting that
speed. Good boy. All right. So with 60 seconds left, Troy still has plenty of time.
Great.
45 seconds.
5 seconds. He feels confident that he's gonna go for a second pour, Joe. Not loving the choice.
I mean, 45 seconds, you need at least 20 seconds to steam your milk, and you need at least another 20 to pour it. So if he had his shot already pulled, or pulled it at the same time that he started his milk steaming, then it's gonna be close, but it's doable.
The problem is every barista wants to pour their best out there, right? And it's a 1v1 competition. It's you got to be your opponent.
No, no, no. Drop the cup. There you go. Take the first one. Oof. And Troy, what are you doing? If I had hair, I'd pull it.
What are you doing? The barista's making it work over here. Yeah.
Oof.
That's clean. That's clean.
Yes.
Let's go, Corey.
Let's go, Corey. Great battle here.
Great battle. Love it when alternates just come up and show up. Let's go.
I mean, call it a coincidence, but is this the same part?
Same design.
Wing 111? Am I seeing this correctly?
Yeah.
Now, who do you feel has the stronger base, right? Is it Corey who actually has it completely sealed? Or is it Troy who is just a touch off on the top on the right-hand side, but has more depth?
Yeah, so that's a tough one. That's why I don't like to be a judge. But, but from, you know, I always like big, wider, in-depth in my wing. Let's see. I think honestly, Corey's got the speed point. Corey's got the symmetry.
Yeah, two nice ones. I mean, these pours are absolutely great.
I think I'm going right with Corey.
Right wins again.
Now.
You think you're going with Corey? I mean, I technically see. I mean, obviously, I'm a little biased.
Yeah.
And why?
Trying not to be biased here.
I mean, I'm trying as well. But I mean, I guess the way I see it is, Troy has given just enough, just as good a battle to what Corey has dropped. But I would agree that if I had to be non-biased, yes, Corey does technically have the better of the two pours.
Yeah, I mean, look.
Yeah, Lena was called up next. That's why everyone lost it. You know how it goes. We're a hometown, baby. I mean, she should have the crown, right?
So with these pours, this is where I go back to having speed point. Troy finished this pour first, but then decided to go for a second with no time. That second decision could cost him the round.
Oh, here we go.
All right, moving on will be Troy.
What do I know, Joe? I don't know.
I mean, looking at it really quick, you can see that Troy definitely had more of the symmetry over Corey. But, you know, it's nitpicking. It's the love game.
Yeah. All right. Fan favorite, Lenitas.
Hometown hero.
No pressure, Joe.
None whatsoever.
Your city's watching.
None whatsoever. And your mentor, because Nicely's up here.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, Lenitas has fans all over. I mean, and yo, much deserve and much love and respect. I mean, yo, there are plenty of people out there who can do it and don't. Lenitas is constantly putting out the contact, constantly doing better, constantly growing, you know.
Yeah, it's going to be cool. But look, don't underestimate Park. You know, I've seen him pour before, though. He means business. And
yes.
If you see his shirt, that's all I got to say.
Hey, let's go. Park coming in heavy and strong as well. It's going to be a battle. Wait, did you see DDN?
I have not seen DDN.
On deck, we have DDN and Justin. We know and love DDN, but we have not seen him yet. So we might have our third alternate. Not sure yet. I know Justin is here.
Wow. I got a pro
scan. You know it's strong when Mr. Boyd is fanboying over here.
All right. Go. The people have come to see Lena pour. Let's see what she got.
Lena is a star. Let's go.
Like Nicely says, you have to respect Mark.
That's right. I mean, honestly, you always have to respect your enemy. Like, I don't care how confident. I mean, anytime I have felt overly confident, never fails. I do something wrong, I overthink, and just don't take it. Why? Didn't respect my enemy. Respect your enemy.
Goes the wrong way. Yes, it does. Well said, Joe. All right. This is beautiful. From two parts of the world, meeting right here in Anaheim for the greatest tournament. Gotta love it.
Hey, what's up, Brianna? How you doing, love? Welcome. All right, Lenitas seems like to be done and going for a second one. Clark has poured, right? No, Clark is about to drop his first pour.
Yeah, he's
leaving him maybe a minute to do another one. Lenitas has at least a minute and 15 seconds, so should be a much calmer and cleaner pour.
Park's looking like he's only pouring once.
Let's go. I respect it.
Yeah. So we'll see. This speed point matters, Joe. So We'll see. She may not get this speed point, but let's see if she can do enough.
Shout out DJ Playlist. That's right. All of those loving the music, DJ Playlist.
Don't worry, New York. We got a DJ for you next year.
Oh, yeah. Let's get it. Oh, oh man. He thought taking speed. Then he thought, right?
Oh,
what?
Way to hard.
Very nice doors.
Did he just fail?
So while he went for that, they need base tulip shape.
Oh, wow. So
nice base layer,
very rare. Lenita's core is a heart. Rare to see a heart at this stage, though.
Yeah, I mean, little shocked and confused, as we all know what Lenita's come for.
Maybe a little bit of espresso won that battle, though.
Maybe. I mean, also, it's not that you can't pour a heart, but obviously a heart tends to be more of a calmer pour, higher level, so it won't really win many competitions unless
it's a
heart.
Yeah, nicely. We'd love to hear your feedback on this. You know, was this part of the strategy, try to get a clean heart, see what the judges got to say?
I mean, it could be. I mean, listen, Sean pours swans, right? And it's going to continue to pour swans.
Yeah.
I mean, Clark with a really good pour.
I know, but he could build right at the end, Joe.
That, I know.
I don't know. That may be points off.
No, the judges are definitely going to. It's going to be a thing.
We'll see. We will see, Joe. Anything can happen here at the Latte Art World Championship Open. Cool.
Well, very true. A well-executed heart is extremely hard. I mean, I know for a fact Nicely has moved on.
Walking. Give it up, guys, for Walking.
And Clark. Clark, moving on. Walking Clark, moving on.
But I know for a fact, and Nicely with all hearts, has made their place onto the bracket with a very high ranking. So, you know, where it is simple, it is also very difficult, but executed properly, it's amazing.
Yeah, I think what I'm thinking, looking back at Lenita's court, I think she was running out of time, and she wanted to put something clean on the court, and with her first court just not being enough, she went with a heart to get something on there. I respect it.
Yeah. Shout out, Anita. DDN, yes. Where are you? DDN, where are you at?
62015.
Okay. We miss you out here, bro.
So Justin versus... Hey, it's our boy from Lucky's. Let's go.
Justin Chow. Let's go. Versus...
DDN, you're in Miami. You're supposed to be in Anaheim.
Probably the flight was to Anaheim.
Yeah.
Not Miami.
No. I can't travel. No worries. We love you, bro.
We love you, brother. All right, we got Jesse.
Let's go, Jesse!
Yeah, representing Lucky Roasters as our third alternate. Let's go.
Third alternate. I'm really feeling this little lottery thing, right? Like I said, it's like the Royal Rumble. You never know who's coming in. It's like,
well, it's good. It gives everybody a fair chance to get up there.
I like that,
right?
Yes.
You know, organized. All right, poor old Curdy in the building.
Mr. Curdy. Also, we got Yoshan up in here. Shout out, Barista League champion.
Yes, sir.
I mean, his boy taking it yesterday.
Yeah, shout out Daryl, man.
Yes.
Doing well.
Yoshan and Daryl.
Cool. So, right here, we got Jesse versus Justin. And on deck, we have Jacob.
And Thanos.
Third place, Barista League. And Thanos, Isam representative. Olo fellow Chateau the Wolf Barista.
Hey.
So I know Chateau is watching.
Right.
So Lena stopped the blue streak, by the way.
She did.
Lena did stop the blue streak.
Park got the win.
Yes. So Wonky two Park. To the yellow.
Two to the yellow.
Right now we have Justin and Jesse, am I correct?
We got Justin and Jesse, Joe. Justin has been a past competitor. He does pour very well. Jesse also fellow barista, competitor.
Great stash.
So we'll see. I know Patty's taught him everything.
Yes.
He knows.
Look, shit, there she goes.
There you
go. Videotaping, proud. Let's go.
There you go. Videotaping. Do it for the gram.
Yes. On deck, we got two of our good peoples, Jacob from the Midwest, and Daniel's team events. One of our guys.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So it's going to be a real tough one.
Yes, sir.
But also, shout out Jacob taking third yesterday.
Yeah.
Barista League. Let's go. All right, so we got first pour coming up by Justin. Here we go. Justin also with another high pour beginning.
Yeah. These cups, man. I guess that's the secret, Joe. You gotta find your right cup for your right pour.
I mean, you know, it's the beauty of also being a seasoned barista, right? Like understanding and knowing, right? Like,
yeah, testing it all.
Yeah, you gotta understand that you might get a heavy espresso, right? So it's like, how do you break it down, right? Or the opposite, right? So.
Yeah. All right. Let's go. Let's see if Jesse can make Lucky Roasters proud. If I'm not mistaken, Jesse ran all the way from his shift, Joe, to be right here.
Let's go. You mean opened this morning and then ran here to
open this morning and got the alternate spot.
Hey, shout out to the bosses letting them leave early to come get an alternate spot.
Yes.
I'll take that. I'll open to then leave early? No problem. I got you. Like, I'll open 5 o'clock in the morning. No problem. I got you.
They love your stash, Joe.
Hey, great stash. Appreciate it.
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Time. Nice job, Justin.
Wow. Yeah. What?
Just get a blood pressure high. Why don't you?
Keep me up on that one.
Oof. Oh, man.
Oh,
I like those.
Wow.
It's like, could you take any longer, sir?
Boom.
All right, Jesse. Well done, bro.
Hey, come on, Justin. There you go.
Yeah.
The people want to see.
There you go.
The people want to see.
All right.
That's a beautiful pour by Justin, Joe.
Two good pours. I mean, Justin definitely taking the battle over the espresso. I think Jesse might have got caught up a little bit, though.
Yeah,
just tripped.
It's been what's been happening today, you know? Darker espresso. These specialty baristas are not used to this dark stuff and getting neat alive. I don't know what to tell you. You know, so... So you let us know in the chat, what should we do with this heavy, dark espresso? All right.
Okay.
Good job, Jess. All right. Yes. I love this. So you got Jacob all the way from Kansas City, and you got Thanos from the slopes of Brooklyn.
Hey, you are BK.
BK in the building.
Like we said, also part of Team Chateau Le Wolf. Hell yeah, go Thanos.
We got the whole Chateau Le Wolf staff here.
Let's go.
No one's making drinks at the coffee shop today.
No one's making drinks.
Sorry. The competition's on. Pardon us.
Shout out Tasa and the crew. Holding it down.
Yes.
Danos, we're at BK. Let's go.
Let's go. go. Take your time, buddy. All right. So I give it up for Jacob. He spent all day at the Baristery, Joe.
Yeah.
So then come here and compete at the Grand Stage.
Yeah, they had 12 amazing teams, and they all put on quite a show. It was really great watching it all unfold. As individuals who put on events, it's always great to see different views and perspectives.
Yeah, 100%. Well, these baristas are not just latte artists. So they can pull a good shot. They can make a good pour over. They can make good mocktails. Right, just the versatility is everywhere.
Let's put 2.5 minutes on the clock for these next two barista competitors. Let's hear for them, guys. Barista's on your mark. Get set. Go.
Danos and Jacob.
Let's go.
Yes, Meech will be pouring. When is Meech pouring?
Meech is over here.
They're
all halfway.
They are scheduled for 3:40. But this usually runs a little back, so you figure about 3:44 o'clock.
Yes. Team and, hydration.
And that's Cali time, by the way.
Yeah. So a little bit behind schedule, but we got everything going.
Uh-oh, coffee by Dre. What's good, brother?
Coffee by Dre. Fun fact, I got to compete with Coffee by Dre. My first ever coffee fest.
That's right, 2018 Baltimore.
Yes.
Let's go.
What a great moment.
Good times.
Good times. All right.
Masalao.
Let's go. Thanos right. Looks focused.
Also, Thanos is pouring pretty quickly. Looks like Jacob's still actually steaming.
Yeah. Looks like Jacob has decided to take his time with every process, which I really like. If you don't rush, you can hopefully get a good pour out.
Who took the last round? Last round went to Justin.
Justin, yeah.
Yes, Justin took the last round. Currently 40 minutes behind. Oh, okay. Thank you for that update.
I do have matcha. Never missing a moment.
Yeah, I appreciate that, by the way. Thank you.
Yes.
Helping us. Thanos taking speed point.
All right. AC coming up soon, yes.
And with 24 seconds to go, Jacob gets to bring up there. Round of applause.
Alright, look at these beautiful pores.
Look at that. Beautiful.
Thanos again doing with that wing face tulip shape. Very nice job. Nice down layer of the heart. A little bit of shape issue that swivel comes down through.
Yeah, Joe. Follow through. Can kill you.
Follow through can kill you. Unfortunately, Thanos had his pitcher a little bit too close to the espresso. Definitely should have had it a little bit higher so it gives it a nice cleaner cut that unfortunately not only drags the heart but then also leaves that little wiggle on the bottom.
Yeah.
Right? Where Jacob definitely has a more cleaner and symmetrical pour. And you can see where he did actually lift his because all of his layers are just bent in as he follows through.
What I'm seeing is you have to go with simple pours. Simple stacks after your wing base. Try to finish it clean. Looks like when you try to layer the stack cards, that's where it gets difficult.
Yeah. I mean, also, Jacob took that battle with the espresso.
He did.
There's a possibility that Thanos might have.
Indeed, sir.
Yeah, not sorry coming.
Yeah. We'll see. Chatella Wolf still loves you.
Love you, Papa.
We love you. It's not the machine, I'm sorry.
So funny, it really is the espresso.
What's up, Mason? We got a couple champions in here. Kyle.
Marf, what's good, brother?
What's
how you doing?
Chris, what's going on?
We're excited to see you out in Orlando.
Cool. Yep.
Kyle, you're a miss out here, brother.
All right, right now.
We are going to have our Pacific Barista Series throwdown, where either Jorgen or Joshua is going to walk away with a $100 gift card from our friends at Pacific Barista Series. Today we're going to be pouring with their soy original.
That's right, they got Spanish milk coming out and the plant-based soy.
Judges are deliberating.
I know, this is actually a really good one. This has got our judges
thinking about it.
Thinking hard.
All right, our judges are
time. Here we go.
Let's see who's moving on to the next round.
All right, well, moving on will be Jacob.
Hey.
Way to go, Jacob. Way to go.
Shout out Jacob and Thanos. Yeah. Great battle.
Great battle.
How'd our judges actually really think?
Hey, how are you? We're doing great, thank you.
You got water, right?
Yeah, perfect.
I'll just take a water. Thank you. No, appreciate that. Thank you so much.
American Express gift card. So what about this competition? You guys get 2.5 minutes to work with this barista soy.
Cool.
And
your
4-1 drinks
submitted. Quick
sponsor pour.
Pacific Foods.
So out here in 2.5 minutes. We'll
that's right. So as well as, you know, traditional competition and battling, they also have a really great plant-based round just to kind of cut the monotony, let the judges get a break, etc. And they'll have either oat, almond, soy, you know, I mean, the beauty of Pacific is they have such great milks, they have such a great variety, right? I mean, they also have like hemp, they have rice, they have coconut.
Yeah. So I'm not sure. The chat is saying that it's birch for the espresso. That's not what the bag is saying, so maybe a little twist to all the baristas.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? On the coffee that they're using.
Let's see if we can find out.
So we'll definitely let you guys know, but it doesn't look like it's birch. But we will find out.
Rob,
what's the bag of coffee? What's the bag of coffee? It's birch?
Yeah, I was asking. It seems dark,
right? Yeah, does this say a different name on the back? Yes, yes. So, yeah, so it looks like there may have been an espresso issue, but.
Should we say something to the judges?
I think they're aware, sir. Okay. I think that maybe coffee was not ready. That's my theory on it. I'm curious to see if the coffee changes for tomorrow. But that has been...
Yeah, espresso has definitely won many of these battles.
Yes, they have been...
earlier I heard you say espresso too.
I hate to say it. Like, we're sitting there, we're just like, all right. They definitely took down the espresso, but unfortunately, this one just may not.
Yeah.
Yes, that's
don't worry,
impressive.
Guys. We're going to get from the bottom of this. We're going to figure out what's up with the espresso. Maybe, hopefully, day two changes.
Inquiring minds want to know, nicely. Yeah. Inquiring minds want to know.
We are just the messengers here. We are here.
Okay, kind of think a relatively rusted coffee would be beneficial for everyone pouring. I mean, yes, as long as it's rested, honestly.
Oh, it's the Emma blend. Okay, cool.
The Emma blend.
Thank you.
Okay, but it is. Who was that? It's birch. It's most likely the Emma blend. Oh, okay. Brianna, thank you for the assist.
Cool. So, yeah, we're doing the Emma blend. And I think that's what's throwing everybody off.
They traditionally use a heavy, darker roast, but this definitely seems to be the heaviest we've seen in a very long time.
Very long time.
Yeah.
Come on for Jorgen.
got a copy for you, Sam.
They're really close.
All right. All right. Cool. Let's go.
One more jump, guys, for Joshua. And for Jordan. I think it's Joshua.
Yeah. Real adjustments will be made for tomorrow, for sure. But, hey look, as my fellow partner Joe says, this is a competition. Sometimes it doesn't play out as you planned. And then you're tested. Today you were tested.
Yeah, I mean, listen, don't get me wrong. The machine should work properly. Your grinder should grind the coffee properly. You should have a decent coffee up there to be used, as well as a good quality milk. I do agree with all of that. With that being said, my high quality milk is different from high quality milk in LA. It's different from high quality milk in the Midwest, right? It's different than high quality milk in Puerto Rico, right? Like it's just different, right? So like these are things that as you as a competitor have to like overcome and realize it and make that adjustment.
Yeah. I'm curious to hear what Nicely has to say. Would you pour thicker Nicely with that heavy espresso? Would you go, is it about mostly just swirling and without that swirl you're in trouble? Would love to hear your thoughts. Would love to hear everybody on the chat hear your perspective on it, you know. But on the stage, Joe, we are back. Action. First side of the bracket's done. On to the second side of the bracket. Halfway done. Who do we have up, Joe?
So right now we have former champion Nicholas Tanaka versus Tafari Daguma.
Ooh, it may be a new face, Joe.
It seems like a new face. I don't think I have seen Tafari before.
Yeah.
So definitely curious to see what we have in store.
So Nicholas Tanaka doesn't always pour at all these, but when he does, the last time he took it all last year.
Two-time champion.
So he's out here defending his
crown,
his Anaheim LA title.
Well said.
Seeing if he can do it again. Got his whole family watching.
Yep. Also, baby bro in this competition as well.
Yeah.
Always placing, always consistent.
He did beat his baby bro in the finals last year.
Will it be a brother battle? Let's see.
But 1 year and not pouring. Let's see what happens.
Oh, sweet. Go tap. Hey, what's up, Bella? How you doing? Hey, where do you know anything on Tafari so we can share it with the crowd?
Let's hear it. Barista's on your mark. Get set. Go.
Shorter shots. Yeah.
Let's hear it for him, guys. Give him some love up here. Come on.
Shorter shots may be the move, Joe. Let's see if Nicholas can figure it out.
Hey. He works at Play Coffee. Oh, okay, sweet. Oh, well, I'm definitely stopping by Play. I've been hearing nothing but great things about this place. Previously at Stereoscope Coffee. All right.
Fellow LA native barista. Let's go.
It's like Bella's showing love. Manzi pours. Bella's a beast. I hope you're good, love. We hope to see you later on today. We got first pours coming up already.
Welcome to the party, Vlad.
1 minute, 30 seconds left.
Cool. Nicholas, a little shaky on his pour, Joe.
Actually, a shake I haven't seen in a long time. He's wasting time
He's looking. He needs to submit that. He's running out of time.
Or at least set himself up. Right?
Yeah.
All right. He looks Nick. He's going with it.
All right.
Let's go.
He didn't really have a choice, Joe. He had to put that down.
I mean, listen, you can always go back for another pour.
You could.
You can always go back for another pour. But is it worth losing that speed point?
Yeah. Or even getting DQ.
That's correct.
Got what you need.
I got what you need.
Let's go and throw those up on the tray for the judges.
Oh, our boy is up next, Joe.
Who we got? Hey, Itsuki.
Itsuki.
And then Linkawan?
Linka one. Oh, Linka June.
What is it?
I think it's Linka.
Oh, Linka June. I'm sorry.
Linka June. Yeah.
Two very nice pours by these breezes. They're already going for that swan shape. Has those nice roots.
We'll see. All right. We got our second swan of the day. God, I love it.
But Nicholas growing something different. I was expecting his traditional flora.
Yeah.
So shout out to Nicholas growing something different. You know, it's always good to be comfortable, but you never truly grow till you do something different.
Yeah.
Nice and symmetrical, very center to the cup. That's nice structure. Two very nice pours. Have a round of applause, guys, for both of these amazing pieces.
It's hard to get a love from swans over here, Joe.
Yeah, I mean, it's also just really hard to judge a swan up against, you know, something that is symmetrical, that is all this, right? Like, the swan will just never be symmetrical. There are ways to make it, but...
Yeah. It needs to be perfect, I always say. You need a strong base, strong neck, strong head. But I think Nicholas may have had enough.
Our check is already. Let's see who's going on the next round.
Okay.
Nicholas moving on. Hey, Sandra, how you doing? I hope to see you next week when I'm down in Miami.
Yeah. Still, you know, I see what you're saying. It is tough, you know, with a swan, you need to have a full wrapped on base. But love the attempt of the swan. Always got love for the swans.
Yeah, and I mean, I guess also the thing with a swan is all your lines just need to be strong, and that can be very difficult with the whip back or not getting enough on the neck to get into a good head. So
it's true.
All right. So Leslie says, for me, a swan symmetry is judged by its wings. There you go. Okay.
Okay.
To the composition, to the body, and head.
Sweet. All right. There you go. Heard it from the expert himself.
That's right. Three-time champ.
Three-time champ.
Or is it four? Is it four? Nicely. Three or four? Where you at?
0-2-9.
Oh, we got Max Alternate.
Right.
Yes,
that's
Julie!
Woo! Fellow New York barista representing Coffee Projects.
And just truly one of my faves. We love Julie.
Yeah. I think she's been a barista less than 2 years, Joe, and... Already a manager in Coffee Projects, killing it, competing at the national level.
Yeah, I was going to say Julie placed fourth, if I'm correct, in nationals, which is great.
Yeah. So, very cool to see.
Y'all making me hungry for four, bro. Listen.
We've been waiting.
If Cabo came out for Louisville, there ain't no reason why you shouldn't at least once.
Turner is here too.
Orlando is pretty in the wintertime.
It's true.
Just saying.
We'll take you to New York.
Sitting at the Tres. Let's go. That's right. Julie is bad. I'm excited for this one.
I'm not going to lie, nicely, I would love to see it, but that's just me as a fan.
So right now, up on the machines, we have Itsuki and we have Julie. I do not know much about Itsuki, but what I can tell you is that yesterday, while we were setting up the camera equipment, etc., Itsuki was just standing here. Practicing his watering pour. Yeah, just practicing his water pours in front of the judges' table as if he was there. I mean, if you can't have appreciation and love for that, then I don't know, man. I mean, I'm excited for both.
Yeah, it's going to be a great round.
Good bounce.
Right. He's been waiting for this moment for a very long time, so let's see.
And his hat game is on point.
Yeah, I mean, styling, profile is awesome.
Let's go, Julie.
Let's go. Go, Itsuki. And why would be another feather in the cap? Ooh, we'd welcome that.
Cool. Let's do it. All right. So what do we have on deck next, Joe?
Yes, we will be in Orlando, and we will be going live with all this stuff.
Yes.
Definitely the new look moving forward.
With captions, hopefully.
We're working on it.
We're working on it.
Right now, Suki, in front of the judges, just like we said, the way he practiced. And I respect it. You know if your pour is going to be good or bad from the beginning. If your milk is not good from the first drop, don't try to continue. Simply throw it out and start all over. Give yourself as much time as possible.
Yeah, I mean, look, it's challenging. It's challenging. This competition's hard. You want to pour your best. Doesn't even seem like he finished the first pour, Joe, so
yeah,
he's got to commit to this second one.
He does, but at least, like I said, if right off the bat you notice your milk isn't good, don't continue trying to pour and try to save that pour. Just stop.
Yeah.
Completely pull another shot, completely re-steam your milk, because you know what you steamed before. You can adjust.
Yeah, I mean, everybody knows when that first wing doesn't go the way you want it to go, it's time to let's go.
Jump ship.
Jump ship, bro.
Jump ship. All right, and Julie taking the speed point.
Julie with the speed point. Let's go. Let's go.
Itsuki. I love
this. Same position he was yesterday, yep. Practicing right here, the Granite Stage. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done.
There we go.
All right. On deck, we have James versus Nico, the rogue barista that is in the building. Lucky Roasters in the building.
Yes. Right now on the screen, though, we have Julie and Itsuki. And you got a beautiful wing, 1, 2, 3 hard on the top. This pour, when executed, can be absolutely stunning. Emily Bryant is infamous for dropping that one. And then Julie, where it's a strong, where it's a heavy pour, unfortunately may have lost the espresso battle.
Yet again, sir. Yet again. Another one bites the dust.
And another one.
And another one. And that's what I keep telling people. You got to simplify your pour when you're up there, especially today. Like, the over-complex pour, layered pours are just getting swallowed by that espresso. I think Itsuki has gotten this one.
Gio has not gone up, by the way.
We got a couple big hitters coming up, Joe.
Yeah.
Gio. We have James Davalos and Nico Vincent.
Yeah, I think Gio is 1 or 2 matches after this. So 3 matches after this, Gio will be up. So Gio is not poured, for those asking about Gio.
Yep, I think Wright has won this one.
Yo, what's good, Trill? It's been forever, fam. I hope all is well, you know, cooking for the celebs. Proud of you, baby. Let's go. BX, stand up.
All right.
I remember milk being weird at Anaheim 2 years ago. That's what I'm saying. I mean, like, me, my biggest worry in any of these competitions is always the milk. Because the milk is just going to be different. Even if it's high quality, even if it comes from the same, like, Whole Foods or whatever store you're used to, it's still going to be different.
It is. Everything's going to be different at this highest level. It's hard to train for. I believe it's a mental battle that these baristas are going through, right? So we all know they pour excellent. We all seen the Instagrams. But if you don't have your mind right, the espresso will eat you up.
Yeah.
All right, judges, we'll see you soon on the next
round. Hey, Nasli, Donnie didn't make it this trip, unfortunately.
All right, we have a unanimous decision. Moving forward is going to be Itsuki.
Give it up, guys, for Itsuki Miyagi on the middle line.
It's Suzuki.
Once again, it doesn't have to be the most intense, difficult pour. Sometimes just clean, symmetrical, and simple can really go a long way. May not get you to day three, but definitely get you to day two.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, you have to view every round differently. The strategy for his first round is clean, simple, get your speed point if you can. When you go into the later rounds, that's where the complex comes in. But Joe, if the espresso doesn't change, this may just be what it is all 3 days, and this barista's gonna have to figure it out.
Hey, I mean, at least day two baristas will understand what to do. But I am unfortunately feeling just a little for the day ones, but once again, this is a competition.
We chef. We'll see.
All right. Let's go, James.
All right, Nico. James.
Let's go, Nico.
All right, you got this.
You got
Barista's
this.
Barista's on your mark. Get set. Go. Let's hear it for him, guys.
Yes.
Whoa.
Let's go. All right. So James and Nico, and then we have David and Aran. Up next.
Let's go.
Cool, so
I think this is David. Is this David? No, it's a different David.
Different David. But love to see new faces, Joe.
Yes.
You know, I know everybody's watching. I hope you guys watching over there are looking at this and seeing like, hey, I can come to Orlando. I can apply. We want to bring this to the next level. Get more viewers. Get more new faces. Just grow this beautiful competition that we all love.
Yeah, man. Milk doodles. That's what it's all about. But it's not just about that. It's about coming together. It's about meeting people you talk to already on social media. It's about building those connections, possibly starting something out of nothing, you know. And now all of a sudden you're live at Coffee Fest.
That's right. Let's go.
Yes. All right. We got. Shout out the cheerleaders, the fans, the co-workers, everybody who comes out there and just shows that love. Oh, Nico taking speed point. Let's go. Levy, what's good, brother? How are you, man? Yeah, I mean, yo, dude, share some of your experiences, man. Let us know how that first time was, because I know this was your first one out in Louisville.
Right. Cool. Vintage James usually going with the slow Zetto. Let's see if he does.
But also just, you know.
Very minimal shake from James.
Let's go.
That's great to see. That's great to see. It's great to see, James.
Oh snap, Henry. Uh-oh. Where you been, mama? Donde tu estaba?
The group chat champion, common champion, here, laying it down.
Well said.
Well said.
There we go. Oh,
with the slow Zeta, Joe.
This is good. I mean, all right, so.
All right.
So we know our judges love strong heavy lines, right? So James is actually pretty minimal shakes. It is symmetrical, so to say, right? Like coming down the middle, right?
I mean, yeah, it is symmetrical.
I mean, slow setters are interesting to judge as well. But no knock on Nico's. I mean, I think if Nico just had a more clearer heart up top, then it would just be Nico's hands down. But I think the fact that James got that full heart up there is going to give him at least a run for his money.
Yeah, I agree. We'd love to hear what you think, Senor Henry. Who do you have, chat? Who do you have left or right?
Hey, that's what's up, Brian. I'm happy to hear it. Let's go.
I'm a sucker for a good slow Zeta, so in it. And, you know, I might not know everything, Joe, but it think I may give it to James slightly, just because of like execution, right? The contrast is there, the symmetry is there. He did lose spoon point, right? Nico does have that wing base, little wonky.
First and foremost, shout out to baristas who have clearly taken down the espresso on this round. These are two good pours. Even though Nico may not be as clean, clearly has a strong heavy pour. And once again, shout out James going heavy. Look
yeah.
at this.
Leaving
it all there.
Leaving it all there with no shakes, Joe. He's known for shaking on the biggest stage.
That's why we love James.
And experience will get you somewhere, you know what I mean? So, and let's see if he's rewarded with a nice W on day one. You know? Nico, we do want to say that Nico did get speed point, so that is something to consider in this. Yes.
Oh, I'm liking the weight of the right move. Honestly, let's go.
Yeah.
Rogue Barista with the dub, yes. I mean, we also know, Henry, you're a little bit biased towards rosettas, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. We'll see, you know, it's super hard.
Love you too, Steve.
Well, it's super hard, you know.
Come out here and say what's up.
Yes. We will see.
Except the sky.
This is a tough one.
Shout out Richard's Rainwater.
Yes.
You know the vibes.
Know the vibes. What I like about what I'm seeing from the judges, Joe, is that they're really having some heart-to-heart conversations about it. So it's great to see.
Yeah.
Moving on will be Nico.
Oh, wow.
What do we know? We don't know. You know, Nathan, you got it right. Great job.
I mean, listen, you know, all you want in a competition is capable equipment and valid judges, right? You know, you just, like me, I don't mind if I'm losing because I messed up or if I lose because someone took me down, as long as I have an opportunity to actually win, right? And if you don't have good judges, then that doesn't happen, right? So shout out to Coffee Fest for always getting creme de la creme out here to make sure that everything is on the up and up and you have every opportunity to go out there and
yes.
represent.
San Fran in the building.
Yes,
San Fran out here. Well done, Nico. Just did just enough to get him by. That's what it's about. Conquering the espresso.
Oh, Aya feels robbery. Dun, dun, dun.
All right, guys, do it. I'll finish on the clock.
Actually, he was like, I fucking do it. Yeah, I mean, just great job, James and Nico. Let's go.
Great job. Great job. We got David and Aran up on deck.
David
up
and
to
Aran.
The machine.
I think I had the pleasure of going up against David. Beast. Very quiet forward.
But they mean business.
Yes.
They mean business. That's...
Well, listen, you don't have any time up when you're up there, man.
It goes so fast.
It's ridiculous how fast this time goes.
You got to temp correctly. You got to pull your shot correctly. You got to press the button correctly. You got to steam correctly. It's a lot.
Oh, yeah. And we are winding down on our competitors. So, yeah. Once again, we have David and Aran. We have David on the blue machine and Aran on the yellow. Blue still dominating for the most part. On deck, I got
1:30
Yoshinori versus Christian.
Yeah, Christian Bach, Christian Holmbach, that's what's up. All right, I know we got some Christian fans in the chat.
So the machines that they are using today are Synesso MVPs. Two group heads.
Yes, Christian's up next.
I mean, two beautiful machines, workhorses. They don't break down. And one of my faves about Synesso's is that the parts are easy to fix and remove. So,
all right.
Highly recommend.
With a last second clean of the cup to not lose that clean point.
David,
way to go, David. Way to go.
Did that in what, like a minute? Oh, like a minute and a half.
Yeah.
Well done.
Yeah.
Ron hasn't even started pouring yet. Got a lot of Christian gangs in here.
Let's go.
Let's go. Oh, what up, sis? Got the sis in the chat.
Hey.
Nice.
20 seconds.
Joey, what's good, baby? How are you, pa?
What's up, everybody? Thank you for being out here 68 strong.
That's
coming.
Right, man.
Let's go. Yeah. We're trying to shoot for that 100.
Shout out. Thank you.
Tell the friends, tell your customers. Express State of Mind Live, day one at the Latte Art World Championship Open in Anaheim.
Tell a friend to tell a friend.
Let's get this to 100.
Ooh, all right. Let's go.
Oh, let's go. Oh, my.
Let's go.
Ooh. But.
Wow.
Now, the question is, did David do too much and could have gotten a cleaner pour with maybe one or two less? Or even though Iran really has those thick, heavy lines, which is beautiful, and has that frame, which the judges do like.
I love the bangs, Joe.
Did they do too little?
Yeah. Yeah, we'll see. I'm a big fan of Ron's pour over here. It took his time.
This is really great. I mean, listen, those fangs coming in,
yeah.
I mean, listen, that's the same pour that took Lenitas all the way to top eight.
Yeah.
So, I mean, doesn't always have to be involved. It can't just be simple and to the point, right? Like strong and heavy.
Yeah. They conquered the espresso.
Yes. They that conquered is. The espresso. Well done.
Yes.
Oh, let's go. So who do you guys got out there, man? Drop it in the comments. I got one on the left. I got two on the left. Who's there? Who else we got?
Yeah, I think we got a couple of lefts here.
Yes, I agree. We need a view of the bracket.
Oh, okay. Can we give him a view of the bracket?
Not like enough, dude.
Cool. We can go right here.
So how does this?
Oh, yeah. We can go right here. I don't know if you guys can see, but we're gonna do our best. Pardon my handwriting, but yeah, you may not be able to see, but yeah,
something we'll definitely work on for
tomorrow. We'll definitely figure out how to add the shot to the bracket.
Oh, let's go. So Aaron's got the harmony, and David's got the symmetry. I don't. I mean.
I could see that. A little to the left.
This is a good battle. I mean, I thought Iran had a good opportunity to take it down, but
yeah. Twiz, I think you got that right. David did get speed point. He did have symmetry, difficulty. So even though we like the fangs, come on, Ron. This is a point system, and majority points, you just need four to win.
That's correct. So right now we have Yoshinori on the blue machine, and we have Christian on the yellow. By the way, whoever was looking for Gio, Gio is up on deck.
Cool. Let's go, Christian. They love you out here, Christian.
Christian has only been in coffee for 9 months, and when he qualified for nationals for USBC this year, he had only been in it for 2 months. That's amazing. Well done, Christian.
Yeah, well done. Looks very serious, dressed in all black. That means he means business. Yes. ETA on Casey. Where we have?
Casey's all the way on the bottom, so 356, and right now we're at 320. So you figure ETA on Casey anywhere from 30 to 45 minutes.
Yeah.
I wish I could give you a closer estimate, but the times are just so delayed, etc. I'd rather give you a
We're moving.
Yeah.
Let's go. We are first round. It's always the longest, Joe. We got 64 baristas. We got beautiful pours.
Patty France is scheduled for 4 o'clock. So Patty is scheduled for about 45, 50 minutes from now. All right, so just to give you all an update, unfortunately, the bracket that we have will just be too small to show you. So if you want, you can go on to coffeefest.com and look up the actual bracket to see where we're at. But at the same time, drop a comment, drop a question. More than happy to update you and let you know when the barista you're looking for will be up.
Yeah, and we're almost there. We're almost there. Christian looks confident. For all the fans, taking deep breaths. You got to remember to breathe here, Joe.
Yes.
I think that's one of the first things I learned about this competition. Had to breathe.
Well, it's not just that you have to breathe. I mean, it's one of the easiest ways to control your heartbeat. And your heartbeat is what's making you shake. It's all that adrenaline, et cetera, right? If you've ever shot a gun, they tell you to breathe when you pull the trigger so that you're pulling it at your most promise. Same thing with a pour. My first drop, right before it, I take a deep breath and then I slowly exhale so that I have as much control on my hand with as little wiggles as possible.
Oh. Looks like Christian was going for the speed point and I think he spilled and I think he's going to clean this cup.
We got a battle.
We got a battle.
We got both cleaning cups.
Both cleaning cups.
Who's gonna get it?
Looks like Christian
Who's gonna get it?
Christian with the speed point.
Let's go. Nah, Maddie, thank you. Hey, listen, the Maddies, the Twizzes, the Nicelys, you guys gotta understand and know that you all set this up for us. You all gave us the vision and made us want to do this. So shout out to you guys. I'm just glad and happy to have you here watching it with us. Truly means the world to have you all up in this chat. Just kicking it with us. That's what it's about.
And now back to the action, Joe. We got Christian.
It's a Nakaport and he won.
Yoshiyomi. Joe, that may be one of our best pours tonight.
Ooh, let's go.
Ooh. Yeah. For all the Geo fans, he is on deck. So let everybody know at Honest to tune in right now at Espresso State of Mind Live. Geo will be up.
Yeah.
Nashville in the building.
Yeah, I know everyone's seems like a Christian fan, but Yoshinori definitely has the stronger of the board.
Yeah.
But looks like another Espresso took down
Yoshinori.
So Yoshinori, beautiful, strong, heavy bass. Espresso once again getting the better of one of our competitors.
All right.
Good pour.
Yeah. We got a couple upsets.
Upsets? I don't know. Do you have any upset?
Well, Lena lost to Mark.
Lena was probably an upset. Yes.
Yeah.
I would say that.
Yeah.
What about you out there in the crowd? You think there was any upsets other than Lena?
Yeah, I think, yeah.
And I don't even think it was like an upset. I guess we
everybody's
expected.
Yeah.
We expected a little bit more out of it. You know, like don't want to say bad job or anything like that. We love Lena. Much love and respect.
Yeah, look, it's a hard competition. You know, they all have the same caliber to pour really clean. It just matter if you can do it right now when it counts. So cool. So we got Gio and Anderson.
Let's go.
Let's go, Gio. Let's go, Anderson. Let's go. Both baristas can pour. This is going to be a battle. If you don't know Anderson.
That's right. I was saying Anderson
can make some noise. So
it's going to be fun. Yeah, I was going to say, Gio's a... clothing game and swag is just always money. You're like in the fucking bag, even like matches the outfits.
All right, cool. So, Kyle and Juwan on deck.
Yoshinori took down Christian Twist.
Get set,
Hip hop power, that's hysterical. I love it. Let's go.
All right. Cool. So, a lot of people in the chat for Christian. It's cool. Cool to
Much
see.
Love. That's
Thank
nice.
You for everybody tuning in. You know, we definitely want to get all the fans tune in to their favorite barista. This
oh, yeah.
is why we do it.
Yeah, it's one of the reasons why we're putting this up. And we try to give an advance notice on it, so that way baristas could also be like, hey, you want to catch me pour, right? You know, don't have to travel to 2,000 miles. Jump on the grid. Jump on the ground.
Yeah. So.
Coffee business, you need to subscribe to Keys to the Shop podcast, hosted by the one and the very only Christopher, our head judge. He has only the best.
And we have Gio already with first pour. Gio. Striking fast.
But honestly, truly, all joking aside, it is an amazing opportunity to talk to some of the
One of my favorite baristas, Joe. Gio can free pour, wing tulip, do it all. Looks like he went for a wing tulip.
Extremely versatile and probably some of the very best, you know, happy first sips. One of my favorite things every morning. Gio really does make the best first sips.
So it looks like Gio has finished his first pour, but may go for a second one.
One left, barista.
He's definitely going to pull another shot.
So we'll see if that's worth it. This is the game we play, folks.
I know, I was going to say.
Is it worth it? Looks like Anderson likes a pour. Oh, no. Maybe. Maybe, yeah.
No, he doesn't have time.
And submitting.
Anderson's going to take that speed point. 35 seconds.
So it hurts me. They don't have time, but they go for a second pour, Joe.
I mean, listen. In that moment, you will think you have time. Right? So this is where it really becomes tricky, because you have to literally tell yourself, no, you don't.
You have to pull your best.
Because right now, once again, Gio did not have the time and had to go with his first, right? But once again, now just lost that speed point because it's his first pour, so you might as well just drop it anyways, right?
Could have had speed point, but didn't, so let's see if it makes a difference. Oh, what a clean pour by Gio.
That's good. Oh, by Anderson, look at that too.
Yeah, no, they're both doing good. Little symmetry for Anderson, which may cost him the round.
What do you got out there? This is a nice, good battle. I mean, Gio definitely has the stronger lines and symmetry, you know. Anderson is just a touch off, so... Unfortunately, doesn't go towards him because everything else is just going to be a little off.
Yeah, I think Anderson realized he couldn't go for a second pour. He went for the speed point.
On deck, we have Kyle Lowe and Juwan Bang.
All right.
Also, who's been your favorite pour today? There's been a lot of beautiful pours out there. Who is your favorite?
I think Yoshi Orni was probably my favorite pour, Joe. The match before this,
yes.
Beautiful wing, probably
Yoshi
the best
Nori,
wing.
One of the strongest and heaviest pours, yes.
Yeah. So
I do agree with that.
Keep out for that name. They can make some noise.
Yes.
I think what Gio thought, he thought he could do something better, but to be honest, you, that's a good first round pour.
Yeah. So, third judge. Wait, hold on a second.
Gio
moves on. Moves on. But Twiz, third judge is CeeLo Kim, fellow LA native.
Marcelo.
Marcelo, let's go.
At the blue.
Alright, welcome to the stage. Our next
discussion
is up again for
Kyle
Yang and
Juwan
Bang.
Kyle Juwan.
Hey, what's up, Yaz? Yeah, this is something we brought out in Louisville and worked out really good. So just working on making it better, but
now everyone gets the true latte art experience, no matter where you're at.
Yeah. Why not, right? It's better than just looking at a screen for as you get to see our beautiful faces, talk some latte art with you guys, and maybe give you a little bit of that spark to see you guys in Orlando right here.
Let's go.
All right. So do we know who we have on deck?
That's a good question. Right now we have Kyle and Juwan. On deck, Emily versus Mateo. We got two world champs coming up. We got Emily, followed by the Immaculate One. Let's go.
Ooh. New York hitters out here coming towards the end of this bracket. You do not want to tune out. We'll see. Either Emily or Prof can win this competition.
Yo, very true.
So it's great to see them come up. It's great to see New York being represented.
Keeping up with Mimi, Leah did already pour. Unfortunately, Leah did not move on, though. Just to give you a heads up.
Yeah. We are on the right side of the bracket.
Yes. We are on the right side of the bracket. Right now, we have where it says 23 on the right side of the bracket. It is Kyle versus Juwan with Emily and Mateo on deck. Last round winner
was
Gio.
Yeah. So Gio from Nashville, Honest Coffee Roasters representing.
Hey, the little one's coming. Yes, cool. We get to meet him. I'm excited about that.
Cool, let's make Orlando pop, yo.
Yeah. Also, by the way, what else do you want to see, right? Like, want to see commentary, want to see, like, interviews? Talk to us.
Yeah, trying to give you all.
Yeah, we're still in the beginning stages. Let's stop.
All the full coverage.
It looks like Juwan's going to take that 3 points. 35 seconds left for you now.
Yeah, Sam, you're kind of looking towards five. But we're pushing. We're pushing.
Yeah.
Almost done with the first half of the right side.
Yeah. So we have Juwan already dropping his first pour. And then Kyle, hopefully pouring soon, because I don't think Kyle has much time.
It looks like I'm on the ox, right?
Yo. 8, 7, 6.
I love it. This DJ is my favorite competitor.
DJ's killing it right
now. 2, 1 at the buzzer.
Oh! Yes! With the Esom Cup, Joe.
Yes! Let's go, Kyle.
Well done, Kyle.
Well done, Sal. Well done. Ooh, this is a good one.
Okay.
Once again, shout out the Espresso. Giving our competitors a run for their money today.
Yeah.
All right, looks like two beautiful pours here. Looks like we have two beautiful wing-based tulip shapes.
Oh, man. You can just see how the espresso just eats the pours out. Look, I ain't trying to lie to you guys. You know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah, barista problems.
I know.
I mean, with that being said, I mean, I do like Juwan's wing base. I think it's pretty cool. It has a nice frame from that second ripple on the inside, right?
Yeah. I believe Juwan got a speed point, too.
Yeah, so. Actually, Juwan did win the speed point.
So.
On deck, we have the Emily Dryan.
Oh, Twiz, you say it right?
You say it right.
You think Kyle has a stronger first base than Juwan?
We'd love to hear your perspective on this, Twiz.
Word.
With a silent block, soft wide.
Yeah. Kyle does have that top part, which, you know.
Does have the top part. And the base is a little cleaner. There's no, like, dribble coming through, right?
We'll see.
All right, so nice these
down
right.
Point system.
I give it a Kyle. All right, so we got it to the right. All right, let's see.
Yeah, nice. The champs know best.
Yeah, right.
rare.
Well, this is at least a good battle. I mean, they're giving our judges a run for their money. It's been a while since the judges took this long to figure out a decision. And for those who are wondering out there who don't know, all three of our judges do have a score sheet, so yes, to say, where they are looking for specific categories, and you get a point per category. And the one with the most points tends to move on.
Yep, Joe. So it's not always difficulty that wins you the tournament. It's not always symmetry. It's not always speed point. So it matters. 4 points over three. That's what sometimes I miss, some of the audience miss. It is a point system. You got to break it down. So we'll see.
All right, judges, let's see who's moving on the next round.
Just for semi-limited, damn near impossible to make it accurate, just without the speed.
Moving on is going to be...
Fair enough, Maddie.
Kyle.
Hey.
Fair enough.
Well, the champs are once again right.
Yeah, the champs are right.
And Team Blue continues to crush.
All right, next up, welcome to the stage.
Let's go, M. Scumbag. So right now we got Mateo and Emily
at the brewery.
Let's do this. 2.5 minutes on the clock. Let's hear from our next baristas on your right.
Battling it out.
Get set. Go.
MC Square, as I like to call her.
Oh.
Two-time champ.
Two-time.
Versus Mateo.
Yeah. Fellow content creator, full time, oh. Joe.
Cool, Mateo or
Emily Bryan.
Let's go. Love Emily. Her videos are the best.
Seems all smiles from Emily Bryan. But this is good feedback, guys. Thank you. We're gonna work on creating a clear picture for everybody at home to see how accurate these scores are compared to what the camera is telling us.
Let's go, M.
Here.
Yo, Hub, I don't know if he's gonna have access to power. We don't have enough power. I like that.
1 minute, 25 seconds left.
Our goal is always to bring this energy and excitement to the world, to the masses. You know, I mean, like, they got cornhole competitions on ESPN. Like, cornhole competitions, right? The fuck can't we do barista competitions up on there, right?
Plug that? Can you plug the port? All right.
So we got our two fours down, Emily and Mateo. Our Mateo cleaning his cup and then dropping. There we go. No, and listen, we're not taking it as like complaints or anything. No, we want this. We want the critiques. Like, this is a great thing. Trust me. Yeah. If you can't see the fine lines, that means that maybe we might have to get a little bit more stronger of a camera or something, right?
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah.
But we don't know this if you don't say nothing. So.
Yeah. No. Look, we want to give you guys accurate visuals of these pores, right? And something that we'll work on for Orlando for sure.
How dare I disparage cornhole? I am not disparaging cornhole, sir. I'm simply just stating they can throw a motherfucking cornhole on ESPN. Then we can get some latte art up there, too. That's all. Much love, brother. I hope the leg is feeling better, man. Or ankle or foot.
All right. Look, we got the pores, Joe.
We love Papa Tanaka. He comes out to all of you. Came out, got the shirt, where's the event, all this other stuff. We love him. He's the best. Shout out to the whole plan.
Looks like our two-time champion may move on. They have done enough. They have conquered that espresso, sir.
Not by much.
Not by much.
Not by much, but Emily definitely had enough.
Yeah.
Looks like our judges are ready. Let's get moving on.
Okay, so moving on is going to be Emily Bryant.
I want to see a top three with all Tanakas. That's hysterical. I would love to see that.
That'd be
hilarious.
Great. Well, the sister's starting to pour, so that actually may happen soon.
She'll partner with Staple Pigeon? I don't think I've heard of Staple Pigeon. What's that? Fluky, it's not that M's pour was a little off. That espresso is just a little different up there. It's its own curveball unnecessarily.
Yeah, it's a curveball, but hey, it's good to see the baristas adjusting to the elements, right? You want them to,
sure.
Sometimes at a coffee shop, you're out of milk, you're out of espresso, or the grinder's not working, the shots is, and you have to adjust.
Yeah.
All right, problem's ready. Kilo's ready. We're 2.5 minutes on the clock.
Let's go. Right now, we got.
Your next two barista competitors, let's get hyped up.
We got Caleb and Prof. Prof on the blue, Caleb on the yellow. And the blue continuing the rain.
Let's go, Prof.
Yeah, it's the espresso, man. That espresso is strong and heavy. It's not allowing the milk to flow the way it should, and it's just stopping it in its tracks.
Yeah.
Hence the wobbliness that you saw from them.
Cool. Let's go. Let's go, Josh. That's what I'm talking about.
Split.
Hype it up.
We are legal drug dealers. Come on.
Yes.
I got that shit.
We got that fire.
Word up.
That fire. All right. Two-time Latte Art World Championship winner. Immaculate artistry. Prof a la corn.
They're asking how many days off roast. Not enough, Twiz. Not enough.
It looks like under 3 or 4 days roast show. That's my opinion.
I mean, one could say that it's a nerdy question, but also it's an extremely valid question. For example, whenever we go into outside places and they're like, we're using our cups, first thing we do is start measuring the cups and figuring out 5 ounces, 6 ounces, etc. It's nerdy, but it's just preparation, man. Like, you need to know these things.
Yeah, Maxi, it is the MO roast.
Caleb, baby barista, coming out here to pour heavy. Excited.
Prof out here trying to.
You heard it here first from former champ Fluke. All you need is 5 gram espresso shot. I think that's ridiculous and not good, but I haven't won a championship, so fuck do I know.
It is tough, Henry, but look, barista's got to still steam that milk correctly. They still got to pour. She got the move. Hey, all right.
Blue bottle does 16 gram shots.
All right, let's get these pours on.
As in they pull it or they put it in the porter filter at 16 grams?
right.
Let's go.
All right, Caleb. Wow,
you even give him a prop for my first money. Am I seeing this?
Yeah, that's a challenge. That is a good challenge.
Yeah.
All right. Look, we don't know anything. Chat, tell us who's winning this round. Just I know from the camera, but from what you guys see.
20 and 16 ounces. Holy shit, I'm going to have to try this. Yeah, if we had benchmark, we'd actually pull some fire ass shots. Shout out Joe Coffee. Yeah, this is another dub for the espresso.
Yeah, I think Prav may have just done enough.
Let's go, Kyle. I know you're proud of your baby barista. Let's go. I'm happy you're here, Papa.
That's his first. Shout out. Oh, yeah, he's been working with him.
Yeah, wow. Yo, Kyle. Let's go.
Shout out to you, Kyle. Big up. Good job, man. Kyle. He did really good.
Prav to get the speed point, though. Yeah, 20 in, 16 out is hella wild. That doesn't even make any sense.
Red cup is Prav.
Moving forward,
it's
going to be Prav.
Yeah!
Prav! Prav! Shout out to the man, the myth, the legend himself.
All right.
Two time.
Who we have next, Joe?
Yes, let's go. We got Kim Hawk and Meech.
Right.
Let's go. NYC in the house.
Let's go.
AKA Miami, right? Because Meech is Miami, something like that.
All right. Let's go.
Let's go, Meech!
Meech out here doing headphones. Lamborghini Mercy.
Can someone steal that coffee and ship to NYC? I mean, there's a possibility. We might be able to get you a cup.
We got you.
Or two, yeah. Figure something out. I think we can make that happen.
It's not blonde roast. All right, Meech Molina.
Let's go, Meech.
I
don't know about you, but I desperately need some food after this.
Is a great representation of care, commitment, support, and compassion that is the person Daniel Lee who represents the Barista Los Angeles community.
It should be a free board contest with that, bro.
I mean, it only takes two of them to agree, so that's up to them.
Please make that happen. All right, Kim Hawk, Meech, you ready? Let's do this.
Let's go, Meech!
Huge round of applause for our next two Barista competitors.
Let's go!
Last hoorah! Go, Meech, let's go, Kim.
The last hoorah. You're hilarious, Eric. All right. Shots are being pulled. Milk's being poured. Let's go. Day one at the Latte Art World Championship Open 2023 in Anaheim, California.
That's right. We are...
Oh, shout out to the playlist.
We are more than halfway through the second side, so you figure we got another 20 minutes here or so, and we'll be done with day one. Exciting.
Yeah.
Great pours. Heavy competition. Day two is only going to get that much better. So stay tuned tomorrow. What time, Hav?
2 o'clock.
Right.
5 p.m. Eastern time for all my New Yorkers in the East Coast.
Let's get it.
1 minute, 30 seconds left, Barista. Let's hear it for him. Come on, show some love.
Deciding to go to a second pour, maybe.
No, I think Meech is cleaning. I think Meech is just cleaning their cup.
Cool. All right, Meech.
Yes, Meech is
coming in.
Come on, let's go, Meech.
Let's go, Meech.
Yeah, Meech, taking the speed, boy.
Yeah. Gotta always remember to clean your cup. Very important. You don't wanna lose that point.
Yeah, I don't think it's like massive amounts of like a massive point, but at the same time it when you have two perfect pours, it really does come down to just the littlest of things. And just that little dribble sends you home.
It can send you home for sure. All right. Looks like the nerves may be getting to kick
off. Shout out Color Cold Brew on the gram. Let's go. Let's go.
2.5 minutes.
No, they're giving 2.5 minutes. I don't think you could do 2 drinks in 2 minutes.
No.
I mean, well, I guess you could, but that's just mean. Hey!
All right, Meech. Well done. One of the best pours of the night. Hey,
let's go. Meech definitely getting the dub on that espresso.
Yeah.
Kim Hawk.
Well, it looks like after seeing so many baristas try at it, you know, with discussion, they realize that, you know, you got to make these decisions when you go up there.
Yeah.
Kim Hawk, great dark red sugar ring. A little bit of overreaction, there's some visible bubbles on the outside, a little bit of bubbling on that base layer. Not quite the line clarity that we see in Meech's pour, but two beautiful pours nonetheless. Round of applause, guys. One more time for both these baristas.
Matt versus Josh.
All right, let's go. By the way, that was Meech's first ever Coffee Fest, so shout out.
What a beautiful dub, too.
Yeah. So right now we have Matt versus Josh. Let's go.
Now we're rocking.
Perfect music. Put that up. Put it up.
Go Josh, go Josh. Oh, we got Josh fans in the chat. All
right,
Josh.
That's right, mad love to Josh.
He's looking confident.
What's that?
That's his husband.
That's my husband.
All right.
Let's go, Josh.
He's got the headphones on, so he may not hear us, but the chat wants to know, what is he listening to?
Yeah, any idea what he's listening to? Oh, your kids are watching. Hey, okay. Let's go.
Hey, la familia.
Yeah, I had my kids watching when I did USBC. It was good.
Let's go, Matt. Awesome. Coming in third place yesterday at Barista League. Let's go, Matt.
Matt blue, Josh yellow.
Let's go. The whole family is watching.
Hey, that's my son. Hey, we got mom in there too. Let's go.
Let's go. Oh,
this is great. We got mom, we got wife, we got the kids.
Love it.
Okay. Well, I know Josh came out for Louisville, but Josh was training a couple of baristas, so came out there more for support, etc.
Nice.
So it's great to now see Josh out here. Cause I looked at him and I said, dude, why are you here not competing? You're one of the best pourers I've seen. So it's really great to now see him out here and doing his thing.
He seems focused, Joe. We'll see. We will see. All right.
So we got Josh, we got Matt.
We got Izzy on deck from Houston versus another alternate, Joe.
Ooh, that's good.
So let's see if we have any more alternates in the audience.
Ooh, that's a good question.
Yeah, so we'll see.
But once again, Matt off of his win, off of third place at Barista League. So shout out and congrats to him.
Josh, ready and excited for this one. He had the pleasure of catching him earlier out here with his dad. So excited to see what he brings to the table.
Yeah, super thrilled. Super thrilled to see.
Hey, that's what's up. That's why we're doing this.
So poor, bring
you can be
heat.
You can be at that's the Port right. Authority. You can be on the John. You can be at a library. Be wherever you want. You can watch this. Basta.
All right.
Obey your master.
All right. Let's go. That's it.
30 seconds.
Let's go, Josh. Making the family proud.
Master. Master. All right, so we got 2 second boards coming up. 15 seconds. Who's who?
Ooh. 9.
Oh,
gosh,
drop it, Josh.
Yeah, nice. Oof. That was a close one.
That was close, Amber. Well done, Matt.
All right, nice, Matt. Let's go.
She thick, but she cute.
And Josh, let's go.
All right.
Beautiful boards up on the screen.
Woo! Woo, indeed. Oh man.
On deck, we have Donald Perdomo and his Munoz. No Donnie. Which means we're gonna go for an alternate. Which I'll draw on him. And we're done with Joe.
Cool, so next we got Izzy versus an alternate.
Yes, unfortunately one of our favorites and crowd favorites, Donnie, is not in the house, the barefoot one. But we'll be pouring in his love. You can't see it now, but underneath this table we are barefoot.
Yes, yes, indeed. Joe, all I gotta say, if they don't got an alternate, one of us are going up there. That's all I'm saying.
Oh, there's no alternate?
No,
I'm pouring.
I'm kidding.
Don't do that to me.
I know.
That's messed up. I've been wanting to pour all week now.
I know. Let's go.
All right, our judges are ready. Let's see who's
that would be fucking
on.
Cool, though, right?
That would be hilarious.
That's
right.
Like go.
Moving on is going to be Matt.
Yeah.
Well done, Matt.
Never fun when two of your peoples are up there, but at the same time, well done, Matt. Well done, Josh. Let's go.
Get out your tickets if you're an alternate.
Yes! I saw that he was out there nicely. Good shit. Trust me, you are an inspiration to us, brother. We love hanging out with you, man.
Yeah, Izzy representing Houston. We did an event in Dallas, and he ended up coming in first place, so... Very strong pour.
He hung out with Nicely this morning.
Nice.
Barista number 826027. Short ice. Shake it up a little bit, Barista.
Barista.
862021.
Yes! Yes! Yes!
Let's go. 0-2-1. Shout out 0-2-1, aka Emma.
Emma LaVoy.
Say hi. That's it. Go say hi. Get him, Izzy. Let's go.
Yes.
L-E-V-O-Y. I'm so proud of you. Good shit.
Well done.
Good dub.
So I'm gonna take off and shoot. Not gonna do that. So
she's replacing the barefoot one. She should be barefoot.
A wheel, raffle wheel.
No, just playing.
You make watches, right? For a living. See, that's all you need.
We got a bunch of people in the chat telling us she has to take off her shoes. She's representing Donnie, right? I was just like, maybe? I don't know.
Casey's coming
up. Oh my
gosh. Uh-oh. You ain't got to go home, but you got to get the fuck out of here, people.
Okay.
Who pressed the switch?
Emma, 2.5 minutes
on the clock. Yo, shout out Anaheim Convention Center. Showing what happens.
They are gorgeous. How many got left?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Five matches left.
That's great. Shout out Anaheim Convention Center, showing you the prime example of fucking around and finding out. We are unfortunately a couple of minutes after we should be, and they have shut down the lights.
Cool. We're trying to get these lights back on for the people watching.
Let's go.
Five more matches. Let's go. Casey's coming in. The people have been waiting. They've been waiting to see Casey. We got to give them what they want.
That's right. Shout out Casey, always comes out.
It's dark roasting here.
It's dark. Yeah, the lights are like the coffee. Dark roast.
All right. Emma, no lights, no problem.
Yes. I'm
going to pour out here.
No lights, I got this. No power, I got this.
What if you can get some like lasers and strobe lights over
here? I don't understand, man. A little unnecessary, but hey.
Unions. Well said, my friend. Yes. Well said, my friend. Time to go. They do not care. They'll shut us off, but the show must continue.
Man, we got what? How many more people?
We got 5 matches left, sir.
No, 1, 2, 3, 4.
After this, yeah.
On deck, we have Martin and Oscar. So right now, we still have Izzy and Emma, am I correct?
We have Izzy and Emma.
So Izzy and Emma are still looking to decide what they're doing with their first drink. There's no...
20 seconds left for Reese's. Emma, Izzy.
20 seconds left, 15 seconds. Has anyone poured anything? So it looks like Izzy has poured. Oh, Izzy takes the speed point. So I was like, wait, has anyone even poured anything?
This feels when it's 5 a.m. and we're not open and they walk in on us.
Yeah, exactly how this feels. Yo, this is exactly what this feels like. Well said. This is when you open the shop in the morning and you're not ready, but people start walking in on you. And she's like, do you have coffee yet? No, I don't have coffee yet. Why not? Because we open at 7. Isn't it 7? It's 6:30. Right now, we still have our judges deliberating. Izzy versus Emma. And Izzy moving on. Have a good night, ladies. So in case you're wondering, unfortunately, we have gotten past the 5 o'clock limit and they have shut down the lights at us at the convention center. So we are trying our best to push through this as fastly as possible so we can go from there. No, unfortunately, Casey has not gone up yet, but we are not stopping either. We're going to keep pushing through. Like I said, right now we have Oscar versus Martin, and on deck we have Casey versus John.
Go!
Right now we are throwing down in the dark. That's right, throwing down in the dark. AKA opening up and people rush inside to get drinks and you still got 20 minutes and just open the doors. Lights are still off. You're like, no, people, get out of here. I don't want to talk to you. Yes, right now we got Martin, we got Oscar, two of my faves. Casey's on deck. Competition has been fierce, strong, and heavy. And it continues even into these last couple of matches. Once again, we got Oscar versus Martin on deck. I got Casey and John, followed by Patty versus Sam, and Maddie versus Thalia. Feels like I'm watching Skinner Max for coffee. That's hysterical. Oh, I needed some of that music. Bow chicka wow wow. I found chicka wow wow. You know it. Our barista's bringing it down to the. So Martin taking the speed boy, dropping the first pour. Oscar going back, only with 35 seconds. It's not really much time. 10, 15 seconds just to see him. Another 10, 15 to pour. Might miss it. Hopefully he does have one ahead of time. Nicely, I got Izzy's. There we go.
15 seconds, Oscar.
I got Izzy's my Instagram. I can send it to you.
10, 9. 8, 7,
come on, Oscar.
6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Oof. Let's go. Let's go, Casey. Ooh, here we go. I mean, a more fuller heart up top would have just really truly been the cherry on the top, no pun intended. But well done to Martin. That's a really great pour. Oscar, we're getting a nice full rosetta and thick, heavy lines. May have been beat a little bit by the espresso that just keeps me taking everybody down. There's you, there's your competitor, and there's the espresso. Let's get it. Yeah, no, they're really good pours. I mean, Oscar is fortunately just a little bit more jumbled, and his line definition isn't there right in the beginning. Where Martin's is, it's on point, it's right there, even the wiggle in the middle. Unfortunately, it looks like either kind of forced it and maybe poured a little bit too fast all the way on the top. That's why it's kind of drawing everything in. But I'm also not a judge. What do I know? But they are ready, so let's see. And Martin moves on. I agree, Bella Martin, for the dub. Let's get it.
All right, moving right along, guys. Have a round of applause for our next two groups of competitors. Again, give it up for Casey Lipsiak and John Lopez.
Let's go, Casey. Iced oat mocha with the assist. Thank you, love. Appreciate you. So right now we have Casey versus John. Martin was the one on your left-hand side.
All right, looks like John's ready to go. Casey, you ready to rock and roll this thing?
Hey, we got Team Casey up here. Let's go. Casey on the blue, and I mean, call it a good sign. The blue machine has basically dominated this whole competition.
Get set, go!
On deck, we have Sam and Patty. Should be a good fun battle. Casey always bringing the heat. White shoes on bar. I know, right? How dangerous. Let's go. Anything white I wear on bar is a t-shirt because I took my shirt off. Because I just know it's going to get stained and badly. Like, it's a day where I fucking drop a whole tub of Cobra on me, you know what I'm saying? Let's go. So in case you're wondering, Hav did have to leave because he is running over to set up for our event tonight, which we'll be emceeing as well. We are at Golden Road Brewery over here in Anaheim, because apparently there's an LA location as well. But listen, man, you know, we've been throwing down. We have been participating in this for years. The past year, we've been able to get in as a sponsor. And, you know, our goal with any and all of these events are always to make it accessible as well as fun, entertaining, and engaging. So thank you all for being out there and listening to us jabber. And yeah, man, I'm glad you all enjoyed. Once again, thank you for being here. This is why we do it.
30 seconds, Casey. John, Casey's
gonna
take that speed point.
Let's go. Casey getting the speed point, by the way. Cup does look a touch underfilled, unfortunately, which is never a good thing, but at the same time, John still has yet. And
John submits that drink round.
John finally gets it in that time. Queen of speed, let's go. All right, and pours are going up. Here we go.
Layers from John's pour there.
Once again, Espresso's definitely giving our competitors a run for their money. Maybe something that the judges themselves figure out and try and lighten up a little bit on the espresso. You can see that even with the good heavy milk, they're still having a bit of a struggle to like break through where your milk should just like jump on top and flow. Let's see. With both John and Casey getting some good pours, but
you guys have been an awesome audience. Let's keep the energy hyped. Give it up, guys, for Patty, France, and Sam. That's what happens. On deck, we go. The judges are ready. Let's see who's moving on from this round.
Okay, moving on.
Yes.
It's going to be
John. Give it up, guys, for John Lopez.
So Sam is still pouring. We got all Sam right, on yellow. We got Patty on blue. Second to last battle, day one. Let's go. And in case you're wondering why we are in the dark, it's because motherfucking unions. We're supposed to be here till 5. It is 5:15, and yeah, we only get half the light now. But that ain't stopping us. We're still pouring. Let's go. We got dark roast. We got dark light. Let's go, Patty. Let's go, Sam.
Ready for a line? Let's do this. Patty, you ready? Okay, let's do it. 2.5 minutes on the clock, baristas. On your mark, get set, go. Let's hear it from our second to last competitor today.
Relevant coffee in the house. I know you're proud of your boy. Let's go. Sam's such a good dude. Then we got Patty in the house. Patty with the big headphones. Once again, I mean, there is no right or wrong when you're up there. It's your job to figure out a way to make yourself as comfortable as possible so that way you are using as little moves and things just so that you have exactly enough time to do exactly what you need, right? Me, I've never been a fan of the headphones because I just can't hear my milk and it really does throw me off. But shout out to those that can do it because I always want to put my headphones and put the music that I want to hear, but I also just rather be in the element, you know? But right now, Patty and Sam. So with 1 minute gone, Sam is already starting his first pour. We have Patty still steaming her milk, which is obviously not a bad thing, but once again, this is a timed event. You want to use as much of your time as possible. You don't want to take any of it for granted. So Sam looking like he's finished with his first pour. Probably still has enough time for another one if he really wants. Let's see where he goes. So Sam jumping in and taking the speed point. Patty coming right behind. Saying, I see your speed point with my speed point. Let's go. Second to last battle. We still have one more up. We have Thalia versus Maddie. Hey, Eddie, what's up?
Again, on deck, we have Matthew Heidler and Talia Torres.
Ooh. All right, we got a Sam. Nice wing tulip. Wasn't expecting that. Impressed with this. Let's go, Sam. Patty, Rosetta Revolution. Once again, Espresso just making it that hard to flow. But shout out to Sam, breaking through, getting in some lines. I mean, not as clean, right? But definitely has a nice heart on top. Then you have Patty with the good pour, as in right in the middle of your cup. Has some thick lines, but. That's right, Thalia's coming up next. Shout out to your boy getting his first dub out here. Let's go.
All right, guys, it's that time.
And last.
Last
but not least, Maddie and Thalia. Let's go.
Give it up for Matt Driver and Thalia Torres.
The book bag boy is back. And for those wondering, what does Maddie have in his bag? I tell you, it's a sweater. He says he's always cold.
Yeah. Let's go, brother. All right, guys, let's do it. 2.5 minutes up. Whoa, a little bit low. All right, Matthew. All right, Talia.
Yeah.
2.5 minutes, guys. Our last round of the day. Let's hear it for him. Let's get hyped. On your mark. Get set.
So we got Thalia in the house, NYC. We got Maddie, counterculture Miami. Let's go. Once again, no right or wrong. Maddie's signature is his book bag when he pours. Me, I'm not pouring with a book bag. That makes me uncomfortable, right? I mean, if I had to, I guess. But I want to be as comfortable and loose as possible. I want to feel great when I'm up there pouring. But Maddie, with his signature, getting the book bag on, maybe keeping them balanced, you know what I'm saying? You never know. Hey, what's up, Sasha? Let's go, Maddie, let's go. Yeah, Matt Love, I mean, I've had the pleasure of growing up against Maddie down in Florida and working with Maddie. I've had the pleasure of competing against Thalia and going up and working with Thalia as well. Two just beautiful people and amazing coffee professionals. So be prepared. Last match is going to be a battle. Maddie backpacking. Let's go. The backpack kid. So we got Maddie with his first four already done. Thalia going in for the finish. Matt is wiping. We're trying to figure out, is he going for another? Is he dropping? What is he doing? Playing politics, playing the game. What is going on?
And Matt is going to take that speed point.
So right now, Maddie with the first of four. Thalia with just seconds to spare.
15 seconds.
15 to be exact. But has plenty of time to finish that last pour. So if they weren't happy with their first, they have plenty of time to drop that last one. These are two great pours. I mean, where yes, Maddie has technically a stronger wing base because it's coming all the way up. It's the lines just aren't there. It's not as uniform, where Thalia actually does have more of a uniform, as well as that wing on the inside. You know, then you have a two and a one. I mean, where yes, Maddie has maybe the difficulty because of the way the pour itself frames. I think Thalia might actually have this one. And Thalia is a 15 seed and Maddie is a two. And now that doesn't really mean anything, but just goes to show, like, you know, judges taking their time, not having, making sure this is not easy. We might have an upset here. Now, both my people, so I'm rooting for both of them, but you know, NYC, I gotta stay with my people, so you know what I'm saying?
All right, judges are ready. Let's see who our final barista moving on the round.
Uh-oh, last one goes to?
All right, moving on will be Thalia.
Yeah! Let's fucking go.
All right, guys, it's been amazing.
Holy shit.
I'm Josh, see you guys tomorrow at 2 o'clock for round two of competition. Have a good night. Be safe.
Yeah, I mean, I think it was a good pour. I mean, not to mention, unfortunately, we have seen Maddie pour much stronger and heavier than that. And not that that goes against you, but at the same time, listen, in these competitions, we all know what you can and cannot pour, and it does go into account. Bring your best all the time. I tell people, don't worry about the other person, just worry about what you're doing. My name is Theo Joe. It has been such a pleasure hanging out with you. Stop by tomorrow, 2 o'clock. We'll be back with Javi and myself for day two. Let's fucking go.
jumper. Thank you, Papa.